If you're struggling with a lack of confidence right now, it may be for a reason that you've never ever considered. So how about we take a look? Hey there, it's Ben Angel here, and on my 90-day mission to become unstoppable for my new upcoming book, The Identity Gap, I had to go from extreme fatigue and exhaustion, an issue that I've dealt with my entire life, to having an abundance of energy and confidence to be able to put together a strategy based on countless research and interviews with biohackers, doctors, neuroscientists, as well as a myriad of other experts to work out how do we become our best, how do we have that energy, and also how do we have the confidence to fulfill the goals that we want. And what I found was really pretty surprising overall. Typically, when we look at something as simple as confidence, the standard approach is the psychological approach to go, okay, why don't you have confidence in the first place? Well, that could be a psychological factor, you talking yourself out of something, saying that you don't have the knowledge, you don't have the expertise to talk on a particular topic. But it may also come down to a few other elements. And one of them that I found is a particular nutritional deficiency, and that is magnesium. Now, one of the symptoms of a magnesium deficiency is a sense of apathy. When you're experiencing apathy, it's a lack of emotion. It's that mental kind of numbness. So you're trying to, if you're in that situation, you're trying to force yourself to be confident. And there's a big divide. The divide is between forcing yourself to feel a certain way and simply feeling that way without that kind of force, without the need for willpower. So when we close this gap, we also close the gap between who we are as someone who we currently see ourselves to be as lacking confidence to someone who is confident. Now, what are the steps in the middle here that we can take to close that identity gap really quickly? Well, the first one, and I've spoken about it at length in the other videos, so be sure to check it out, is the various nutritional deficiencies that affect our cognition. Now, if anything is affecting your cognition, it also can affect your behavior. You could go from an incredibly extroverted individual to completely introverted in a very short amount of time if you have a deficiency. If this is the case, in many circumstances, we look at the individual and look at their behavior and blame their behavior instead of going another layer and peeling back the layers to work out what else is going on. Yes, the psychology is an absolute factor in this, but it's not the only factor. So if you try to tackle the issue of a lack of confidence with psychology when it's a nutritional deficiency, you will forever be trying to force yourself to be confident because you're fighting very real physiological symptoms in the background. Once we address that, the personal development work becomes so much easier because you have access to your cognition. As the saying goes, when the soul is willing, but the flesh is weak, the soul is never going to fulfill the mission that it's on. It simply can't. It will forever be a tug of war. So by addressing any nutritional deficiencies, having that energy, having that cognition, your confidence will naturally start to increase because you'll be in the logical mind able to access a part of the brain that can solve those types of challenges. Number two, progressive overload. This is a technique that I have used my entire life, and you've probably used to some degree without even knowing it. So progressive overload in the gym is all about lifting heavier weight each day to stimulate growth. And when we take this principle and apply it to the area of confidence, we want to look at how do we progressively overload ourselves so we stimulate mental growth to the point in which we slowly become that confident person. Many people try to go from here to here really quickly. And what can happen is they can experience what I call the snapback effect. So the snapback effect is like a rubber band. You stretch the rubber band, you're confident in that moment, but you suddenly snap back because your identity, who you are, is too steeped in the past. It's not caught up with who you need to become. So it's like putting a peg in the ground, and that peg could be certain education that you need to get to help yourself feel confident and rely on that education instead of just relying on yourself. And number three, is it a lack of confidence or a fear of criticism? These are two very different beasts. If it's a lack of confidence, that is around specifically potentially a lack of education as well as nutritional deficiencies that are affecting your cognition. Then on the other hand, if it's a fear of criticism, that could simply be a lack of knowledge in your field. And that may stem from something someone has said to you in the past, which could be, oh, you're stupid, you don't know what you're talking about. If that fear is being brought from the past into your current environment, what we can once again do is fill that identity gap with education. So you get to the point where you can say, hey, I know my stuff, and you know what? If I don't know my stuff, that's okay, because I can get back to you with an answer. If you're loving this information, please like, subscribe, share, and comment. We'd love for you to share this with your family and friends who this could really help. And if you'd love to learn more about my upcoming book called The Identity Gap, head over to theidentitygap.co. That's theidentitygap.co. The book will be released via Entrepreneur Magazine and Entrepreneur Press in October of this year. In the meantime, good luck and take care.